As I bring to the podium representatives from JDPC, Mr. Babajide Bambushi, Senior Program Officer, and Anthony Ojedeji, Parliamentary and Senior Officer. So we are going to share 10 minutes at least. So 5-5, or 7-3?
Very wise. I'm willing to support everyone. Let me first commend this CSDP, the way they enter the whole program with Oyo State item. Ashiwa Guniwa. I hope we still maintain that Ashiwa. And let me also commend or greet our partners, the Oyo State House of Assembly, ably represented by the Chairman of Parliamentary Campus, Honorable Adaobu, and Honorable Ibanji. When the speaker was talking to me this morning, saying this on his way, I said, man, what is going to happen? These are people who believe in reforms, which the CSOs have been partners to do a lot of things. As part of parliamentary advocacy, JDPC with the partnership of the House of Assemblies have successfully passed into law 4 major laws. One is anti-grabbing, land-grabbing law, anti-kidnapping, and community service. And this is another one. And we are only requested to showcase this. How the CSOs, partners with government, to get this done. Before the slide, I will go a little bit into memory lane. From 1990 to 2004, the highest allocations to education in Oyo State is the highest, is 11%. Currently, the budget estimate of Oyo State, which is put as 207,671,495,300, while the expenditure for education, which is the capital, is put at 5,302,273,249, which is put at 2.55%. This makes the government also look for the other way to finance education, because of the dwindling resources of the states. And the slide. In the first slide, I give the background context, the question. And the questions we ask is inadequate funding and lack of accountability in management of educational sector, which led to decline in the standard of education. Can you please show slide? Come in, the background. Slide 7, 8, 9. That shows the levels of decay. 7, 8, 9, no. That shows the decay in public schools. His pictures. No. Yeah. This is not the immediate fault of the current administration, but these have been the prolonged neglects in the sectors. You know, I give you the statistics from 1991 till date. The highest, both ex-current and capital projects have been putting at 11%. And this is the resultant effect. Complete decay of the system. So when the governor came in last year, and introduced the education levy that parents should pay an average of 1,000 naira per head. This generates a lot of controversy. Go to the introduction slide. Slide 1. People started asking questions. Is the government not revenged on the electionary promise of free education? People started agitating. If we are channeling other source of funds to education, how do we ensure that there is accountability and transparency in the management of that fund if we have this experience in the past? So, at one of our group meetings, which was sponsored by EU since 2006, we call it Civil Coalition for Good Governance, in Ibadan Southeast, these issues of introductions of funds and the stopping of WAEC fee became an issue.